Hi, I'm here to tell you about new features in Krita 4.1. In my opinion, one of the best features is Reference Images tool. In earlier versions, there was Reference Docker, which was removed in Krita 4. But now, in Krita 4.1, we can work with reference using a new tool called Reference Images tool. So, how it works? You grab it, open Tool Options Docker and press Add Reference Image and choose your picture. You can move it out of canvas, scale and rotate it. Note that you can work with reference only if your Reference Images tool is active. So if I pick Brush tool, press Delete button on my keyboard, I want to delete my reference. But if I grab Reference Images tool and select my reference, I can delete it. You can change the opacity of your reference. Or you can decrease the saturation, which can be helpful, for instance, if you do study drawings. You can add more reference, and if you right-click on it, you can change the order. Like, this image is on top, but I can send it to back. You can also mirror your reference image using right-click menu. And you can also save your references into one set and load them again in a new document using Export Reference Image Set and Load Reference Image Set buttons. There are also these two options, which allow you to choose whether you want to keep your reference in your file as images or as links. The first one allows you to store references in your Krita document, so if you send it to someone, they will be able to work with it as well. Or you can keep your references as links. In this case, if you move the actual file, you will have to move your references as well. Assistant tool. Now, this tool contains different rulers, like lines or ellipses or perspective. In Krita 4.1, finishing point now has one more option, density. Basically, it's how many lines you can see coming out of the vanishing point. Also, since Krita 4, you could change the color of assistant tool rulers. But now, if you tick custom color checkbox for an active assistant, you can color it individually. There is a new function for the color selector tool. You can now pick a smaller portions of color for mixing with your active color. So, in this example, I have my white and red colors. And I set blend about 10%. I pick white color and now I want to move towards red. So, I click on red and now we can see how my color slowly changes. By the way, I use brush tool and click Ctrl key to temporarily switch to color selector tool. So now it's another possible way to mix colors in Krita. Actually, I recommend you to watch Emmet O'Neill's video where he explains it way better than me. You can find the link in the description box below. Animation. First of all, timeline docker has been improved. And now you can better see empty frames and how long a single frame is running. There are also more frame management options, which you can access in the right-click menu, moving, copying, adding frames. And there are also more options for column actions, which you can access in the right-click menu. and you can also assign shortcuts for all of new options. There is a new filter in Krita, cross-channel adjustment. It allows you to work with your image on different levels. For example, you can decrease saturation just for the darker parts of your image and keep light pixels unchanged. For that, I choose saturation here and it's a vertical axis, and I choose lightness here and it's x-axis or horizontal axis on this graph. So I change the curve and this saturation of only darker pixels changes. Before Krita 4.1, you could use Workspaces in Krita, which you could find here on the right upper corner. You could save your workspace or load another one. But when it comes to working with multiple monitors, it's a bit limiting. So now you have two brand new options, Sessions and Layouts. Layouts. Krita remembers the position and sizes of all of your open dockers, even if some of them are opened on different monitors. You can access your layouts here under Workspaces on the right upper corner. Sessions. Basically, sessions include layouts with all your opened documents. You can find Session Manager in the File Sessions menu. Now, when you save your layouts, you can see these two options. The first one means that if you move your cursor on the second monitor, it becomes active and all of your dockers jump on it. This second option simply allows you to open your work on both monitors. About other changes. The circular Gaussian and soft brush tips are now work faster. You can find them here. Also, Krita now supports Python 2. There is a tablet tester now, which allows you to check if Krita can see your tablet or not. Raw files. Actually, Krita could work with RAW files before, but now it supports more formats. You can see all of them on screen now. You can find out about other changes in the release notes. I will leave the link in the description box below. Thank you for your attention, and sorry for my sick voice, really.